Good morning, everyone. Christ is risen. Sure, I want to welcome everybody to this special service this morning as we celebrate the Christ resurrection. Happy to have everyone here. And in just a moment, we're going to stand up like we normally do, and we're going to greet everybody on this special morning. When you come to your seats, I want you to remain standing, okay, this morning. We're going to do it just a little differently. So at this time, if you would, let's stand and greet our neighbors. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the entrance. So she came running to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one Jesus loved, and said, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we don't know where they have put him." So Peter and the other disciple started for the tomb. Both were running, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent over and looked at the strips of linen lying there, but did not go in. Then Simon Peter came along behind him and went straight into the tomb. He saw the strips of linen lying there, as well as the cloth that had been wrapped around Jesus' head. The cloth was still lying in its place, separate from the linen. Finally, the other saw and believed, and they still did not understand from Scripture that Jesus had to rise from the dead. Then the disciple went to where they were staying. Now Mary stood outside the tomb crying. As she wept, she bent over out to look into the tomb and saw two angels in white seated there where Jesus' body had been, one at the head and the other at the foot. They asked her, "Woman, why are you crying?" "And they have taken my Lord away," she said, "and I don't know where they have put him." At this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not realize that it was Jesus. He asked her, "Woman, why are you crying? Who is it that you are looking for?" Thinking it was the gardener, she said, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have put him, and I will get him." Jesus asked her, "Mary." And she turned toward him and cried out in Aramaic, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said, "Do not hold on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. Go instead to my brothers and tell them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, and my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went to the disciples with the news, "I have seen the Lord," and she told them that he had these things to her. If you would, please be seated.
God, this can't be happening. Oh Lord, tell me that it's not real. Tell me that it's just a dream.
Oh God.
Just 3 days ago, we were sitting at dinner with him, celebrating the Passover. We were all together, and it was all so good. And so right, and now it's so wrong. How could I not have seen it coming? How could I not have known that Judas was up to something so I could have stopped him? And how could I have been such a coward? I was standing right there in the courtyard of the high priest where Jesus was on trial. I could have done something. I did nothing. Wait, I did something. I denied I even knew him. Yeah, that's something, Simon. You, the one that Jesus called Peter, the rock. Look at you now. Some rock you are. God.
Peter?
Mary. Oh, it's you. I'm sorry. I didn't expect it.
He's alive. Peter, he's alive.
Mary, what are you talking about?
Peter, I've just seen Jesus. He's alive.
What? Where? How? Where?
At the tomb just now. After you and John left. Wait. Where's John?
I told him to go on ahead. I just wanted to be alone.
Peter, are you all right?
Yes, I'm fine. I just wanted to... Look, don't worry about me. You said you saw Jesus at the tomb, alive?
Yes. I was in the garden, alone. I was crying. And I looked into the tomb, and I saw two angels. I was so surprised, it didn't even occur to me to be scared. They asked me who I was looking for. Well, I was devastated. I had lost my Christ, my Lord, once on the cross, and now again in this empty tomb. And then, out of the corner of my eye, I saw another man. I thought it was the gardener. And he said my name. And as soon as I heard my name, I knew. And I said, "Teacher," and I fell down at his knees. I was ecstatic with joy. And he told me not to hold on to him, and that he was going to go to his Father, our Father, his God, our God. And then he told me something else. He told me to go and tell you and the others.
Mary, are you sure? Are you sure it was Jesus?
Yes, Peter. And didn't you tell me that Jesus had said to you and the others that he was going to Jerusalem and that he would die and that on the third day he would rise again?
Yes, but I never thought that...
Peter, didn't he tell you more than one time?
Yes, he said it three times. Three times.
Peter, you know that when Jesus tells you something is going to happen a certain way,
yes.
Well...
Yes, it comes true. Yes, I know that. Just like when he said I would deny him. Three times.
Peter.
Look, Mary, even if he is alive, he isn't going to want to have anything to do with me, not after what I did.
Oh, Peter, how many times did you hear him preach about love and forgiveness? How many times did you see him offer love and forgiveness to all sorts of people who didn't deserve it, including me? Peter, if he can forgive me, then you must know he can forgive you, that he has already forgiven you.
But I failed him, Mary. I failed him.
Yes, Peter, you did. We all have failed him. But Peter, who better to tell his story than people like you and I who have been forgiven? Peter, he's alive. And I've seen him, and you can see him too, if you are willing. Peter, will you come with me?
Her voice we first heard, those kind gentle words, asking what was her reason for her tears. He said, child, it is I am here.
God, save
Jesus.
I tell you, he's alive.
I've just seen
Easter people, rise and raise your voices high, for Christ has conquered death. Let praises fill the sky. Let songs of joy resound and echo far and near the wondrous news of hope that all the world may hear. The grave has lost its power and death has lost its sting, for Jesus is alive. Come, Easter people, sing. Easter people, raise your voices, songs of heaven and earth should ring. Christ has brought us heaven's choices, heavenly music let. Thank you.
majesty. Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead. Go ahead. Unto Jesus be all glory, honor, and praise. Majesty, kingdom, authority, flow from his throne unto his own, his anthem raise. So exalt, lift up on high the name of Jesus. Magnify, come glorify Christ Jesus the King. Majesty, worship his majesty. Jesus who died, now glorify, King of all kings. Please join in the opening prayer. O risen Christ, you are indeed the King of kings and Lord of lords, for you alone have conquered death and opened for us the door of life. Now may we, by your resurrection power, walk boldly through that door so that we might live fully for you. We ask this in your own glorious name. Amen. You may be seated.
Our New Testament reading this morning is from Revelation chapter 5, verses 6 through 13. And between the throne and the four living creatures and among the elders, I saw a lamb standing, as though it had been slain, with several thorns and with seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God sent out into all the earth. And he went and took the scroll from the right hand of him who was seated on the throne. And when he had taken the scroll, the four living creatures and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb, each holding a harp and with golden bowls full of incense, which are the prayers of the saints. And they sang a new song, saying, Worthy art thou to take the scroll and to open its seal. For thou wast slain, and by thy blood didst ransom them for God, from every tribe and tongue and people and nation, and hast made them a kingdom and priests to our God, and they shall reign on earth. Then I looked, and I heard around the throne and the living creatures and the elders the voice of many angels, numbering myriads of and thousands of thousands, saying with a loud voice, Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and might and honor and glory and blessing. And I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and in the sea, and all therein saying, To him who sits upon the throne and to the Lamb be blessing and honor and glory and might forever and ever.
It seems rather presumptuous of me even to dare to speak right now. When we think about what this day means, when we think about why we're here, the only reason we're here is because of the resurrection. Had there been no resurrection, this wouldn't be happening. Had there been no resurrection, we could not say with assurance, Jesus is here, alive with us. And so as I invite us into a time of prayer, it seems only right that we pause for a moment of silence to just let it sink in. So please, would you come before the throne with me in quiet reverence? Worthy, O Lord, are you to receive glory and power and honor and might. For you, the Lamb, were slain for us. And you have conquered death. And now, because of you, we can live not just some life distant off there in the future in heaven, but here, now, today. Because of your resurrection, we have hope. Because of your resurrection, we have strength. Because of your resurrection, we can see you alive and well, walking with us and leading out in front of us. Lord God, you are the one who is worthy of praise, not us. For you know us. You know our very souls. You know that we are not worthy. You know how often we have chosen our own way, chosen to rebel against you, chosen to just ignore you. And in doing so, we have failed to reflect your character to the world that others might see you in us. And we're sorry. Forgive us, we pray, by the blood of your cross and by your own mercy. Forgive us and free us for joyful obedience that we might follow you faithfully each and every step of the way. Lord, you know each heart here. You know those who have come this morning full of joy and anticipation for this day and this Easter celebration. And you know those who come here this morning with heavy hearts. For life can be hard. You've told us that. And we've experienced it ourselves. And so for those who are burdened this morning, Lord, we pray that your Spirit would come and strengthen them. For those who are grieving, we pray that you would lift their spirits. For those who are questioning and uncertain, we pray that you would guide them. For those who are rebelling, we pray that you would seek them. All of these prayers, Lord, spoken and those that we speak in the silence of our own hearts, we lift to you in the name of Christ as we offer back to you the prayer that he taught us, saying together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I find it interesting that we call this blessed sacrament by different names and different traditions. I know in the Catholic Church and in others it's called the Eucharist, which means the good gift, and indeed that's appropriate. But I like the fact that here we call it Holy Communion. Communion is a fellowship. It's the same base word from which we get our word communication. It's a conversation, it's a relationship. And so when we remember how on the night that Jesus died, he took bread, and after giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take and eat of this, all of you. This is my body, which is broken for you. As often as you eat this bread, remember me. As we remember that, we realize that this is not just a memorial, remembering something that happened. It's a sharing in it. Taking his body into ourselves, communing with him, deepening our relationship with him, growing in our conversation with him. And when we remember how on the night that he died, he also took the cup. And after giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples and said, Take and drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you drink this, remember me. He's not saying, remember me a long time past. He's saying, remember that because of the resurrection, I am here with you now. And he's saying, come. Come, remember. Come, commune. Come, be with me. And our Lord invites to his table all who will come. In the United Methodist Church, we practice what's known as open communion, which means that you do not have to be a member of this church or of any church for that matter. All that we ask is that when you come to this blessed table to share in this holy sacrament, you come with a humble heart, willing to admit your own faults, and come with a desire to follow Jesus faithfully. And so remembering that, I invite you to come as you are ready. and take a piece of the bread. Here. Hear the words of institution. Take the piece of bread, dip it in the cup, and receive it. And then if you wish to remain at the altar rail for a moment to just pray, to just be with the risen Christ, please feel free to do so. But come as you are ready. The table is ready. The risen Christ is here. Having received this precious gift, let us now offer to God our expressions of thanks by sharing our tithes and offerings. Please join in the prayer printed in your bulletin. God of the empty tomb, by your power, you have raised us to new life. As we offer these gifts of gratitude, we pray that they might be used to bring resurrection to our neighbors, both here and around the world. We ask this in the name of the risen one, Jesus our Lord. Amen. I want to just give you a word of instruction here. We'll be singing Because He Lives in just a moment. But after that song, if you would, as soon as we're done, just turn and face the window there at the back, which is beautiful this morning. And the choir will share with us a beautiful number. And then after the benediction, you're invited to remain, come down to the fellowship hall and enjoy breakfast. So let's sing together. God sent His Son.
Death gives room to victory. I'll Thank you.